Welcome to the inauguration ceremony for the 20th president of Reinhardt University, Dr. Kina Mallard. I would ask you, if you haven't already done so, to please silence your cell phones and then stand with us, if you would, for the processional. Thank you.
Thank you. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Extol him, all you people. For great is his steadfast love toward us, and the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever. Praise the Lord. Friends, I greet you today on behalf of Bishop B. Michael Watson, the resident bishop of the North Georgia area of the United Methodist Church. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, whom people of different persuasions call by different names, yet on whom we all alike rely for our lives, our land, and for the opportunity for happiness, grant us a new and vital realization of your sovereignty and of our dependence on you, both as individuals and as a society. Save us as a people from the arrogant futility of trying to play God as if we knew everything there is to know, as if our wealth, our knowledge was so great that we could satisfy the needs of people everywhere over the world and buy their favor and support, as if our power was limitless so that we might manage to direct the affairs of humankind. We ask for your forgiveness for those sins that mar our character and impair the effectiveness of our institutions. Help us as a people to confess our sins and not to place blame on others. For you, Lord, hold before our face a mirror in which we see our own misdeeds writ large. Teach us to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves. Bless this day our outgoing president, Dr. J. Thomas Isherwood. Give him the steadfast knowledge that he has rendered inestimable service to university, church, and larger society. Bless the trustees of Reinhardt University, the newly constituted president's cabinet, faculty, staff, alumni, and others appointed to serve this university. Lend your favor and aid to these persons that they may support and complement in unselfish service the work of the president and the university. Triune God, this day we ask you to pour out the abundance of your grace upon Dr. Kina S. Mallard, who this day is to be inaugurated as the 20th president of Reinhardt University. We pray for her family, especially Steve, her husband. We thank you for her brilliant mind, her accomplishments in higher education, and for her extraordinary Christian life and devotion to you and your people. Grant her the wisdom, the strength, and the goodness to place among the greatest of the presidents of this institution, and grant her, like Solomon, an understanding heart to lead rightly. Make us, we pray, one people under your grace as we endeavor so to live after the example of Christ, as a people who seek to unite the twin values of knowledge and vital piety in service to humanity. This I pray through Christ my Lord. Amen.
I want to welcome each of you being with us here today. This is an important day in the history of Reinhardt. It's a day of celebration. It's a day that we will remember, as I said, in the history of Reinhardt. This is the inauguration of our 20th president of Reinhardt University, Dr. Kina Mallard. We are excited about this day. We're excited to have you with us. And we're also very appreciative and thankful for each of you being here with us. My name is Billy Hasty. I have the honor of being the chairman of the Board of Trustees here at Reinhardt University. Initially, I would like to take an opportunity to recognize some of our visitors and guests. Some of the guests that are here today are members of the university administration. Some will be speaking. Others are here as representatives of their respective positions to celebrate this occasion. First of all, Dr. Martha Shaw has done an outstanding job in preparing and presenting the Reinhardt University Chamber Singers and Brass Ensemble as part of our service. There are many guests here today. I can't really see all of you, but I appreciate all of you being here. There's a few that I would like to recognize, however. First of all, our Board of Trustees. Would the Board of Trustees that are present please stand? We have a good turnout. Thank you so much for... Thank you so much for being here with us. Also, I am delighted to recognize two of our former presidents. Dr. Floyd Falany, he's here. But would you please stand? Is Faye here with you? Is Faye here? Okay. Second, Dr. Thomas Isherwood, would you please stand? Betty Jo, where are you? Please stand. You did a remarkable job as our first lady. Thank you. Next, we would like to represent Dr. Mallard's family. First of all, we have Dr. Mallard's mother, Miss Ann Steed. Is she here? Well, thank you. Hello. Dr. Mallard's husband, Steve Dietz, is where's Steve? Oh, right here, okay. Thank you. And Dr. Mallard's children, if you would please stand. Thank you. Thank y'all for being here. I know you're all very, very proud of your mother. So thank y'all for being here with us. Any other family members that are here visiting? I think there's several. If you would please stand. Please stand, all of them. We also have representatives from our college and universities. We call them delegates. So any of you here, please, if you would stand. Oh, wow. As chairman, I want to personally thank each and every one of you for taking the time to visit here with us. We really, really appreciate it, and we're honored to have you here with us. Next, I would like for the cornerstone of our university to stand or be recognized as our faculty. If you would please stand. Don't you look great? Thank you. Okay, now we're going to have a series of speakers that will introduce themselves as they come to the podium. First of all, we'll have Jamie Palmer with the Student Government Association. Jamie?
Good afternoon, everyone. And I would like, on behalf of the student government as well as the student body here at Reinhardt, welcome you all to this wonderful occasion here at our university. Today, we are here to celebrate Dr. Mallard. From the first day that Dr. Mallard was here, she has been engaged with students. She's been a wonderful person to work with. We have talked about leadership. We've talked about the growth of Reinhardt and growth of students and what this place can do to grow. She is constantly involved as well as engaged, and I don't think she's ever missed a performance, have you? And so, on behalf of the student body, I would like to formally thank you and thank everyone here for attending and coming and celebrating with us on this memorable occasion. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Susan Pinson, a proud 2004 Reinhardt graduate, and it is my honor to be serving as the president of our Alumni Board of Governors, and my joy to bring greetings today on behalf of over 12,000 living alumni representing a wide variety of careers, accomplishments, politics, beliefs, and hopes and dreams for our beloved alma mater. At recent alumni events, we have shared stories with Dr. Mallard, beginning with the phrase, "It began at Reinhardt." For me, an opening of my mind and heart to a world larger than a narrow perspective began at Reinhardt, preparing me for graduate studies at both Duke University and the University of North Carolina, and my vocation. But despite this, one thing remains the same. I remain a proud Reinhardt Eagles fan. It began at Reinhardt, from careers to relationships, opportunities, and lifelong friendships. So much has begun at Reinhardt for generations of students, from the days of the Reinhardt Academy to now as a growing university. When fellow alumni were asked what they'd like to share with President Mallard on this momentous occasion that would ostensibly be used in today's remarks, and yes, I first learned the word ostensibly in Sociology 101 here with Dr. Donald Gregory, a dear friend and classmate put it best. Reinhardt isn't just an experience, it's a relationship. You give all of yourself and the institution reciprocates. I found love on our campus, literally and figuratively. Since I'm emotionally involved with RU, I continue to pursue our relationship. Madam President, Reinhardt is more than a few years. It's standing next to friends at their beautiful wedding inside Hagen Chapel, a newborn baby dressed in a Reinhardt t-shirt, a family picnic under the bell tower where you first told your future husband you'd marry him, a hug 8 years later from the dining hall staff who still remember you stealing trays to slide down the icy hill behind the Gordy. It's dressing up for Reinhardt in the city alumni events to reconnect with your lifelong friends or helping support those friends when tragedy occurs. Life happened at Reinhardt and it prepared us to handle life outside the beautiful brick entrance. Forever yours, Andy Henry Baker, class of 2004. And then there was the late Evelyn Thacker Heelan, class of 1936. She shared this just a few years ago at the age of 94. Recently, I had a dream. I was trying to recall the words to Reinhardt's alma mater. I awoke singing it and was able to finish except for one word. I got online to check how accurate I was, and it was verbatim, and the word I left out was influence. Adding that made it complete. Thinking how I now cannot remember what happened yesterday, I was proud of remembering something from 76 years ago. It amazed me that as I sang, I felt the same pride I felt while attending Reinhardt. Nothing had changed, but actually had heightened as I began to recall the many benefits of my education. I can never adequately express how much I value my Reinhardt education. Dr. Mallard, proud Reinhardt alumni across the generations, join me in welcoming you to the Reinhardt family, and we give thanks for all that you have already begun in this place. We look forward to the next generations of Reinhardt Eagles looking back to say, what a great era began at Reinhardt with its 20th president. Thank you.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Jonathan Good. I'm an associate professor of history here at Reinhardt, and I also serve as faculty senate chair for now, in which capacity I had the privilege of serving on the search committee that brought Kina Mallard to us last year. I assure you, she was the best candidate. And we were ecstatic when she accepted the offer, and she has not disappointed. We are deeply impressed with her energy, with her enthusiasm, with her approachability, with her transparency, and with her support for all that we do. So, Dr. Mallard, I have no words of encouragement for you except to say, keep it up. And we look forward to working with you for many years to come.
My name is Drew Kronick. I'm the head football coach here at Reinhardt. On behalf of the staff of Reinhardt University, it's my pleasure to welcome you today, and it's an honor to congratulate you, Dr. Mallard, on your inauguration. In our football program, we believe there are two key characteristics that you must exemplify if you want to be a champion. First, you must love and invest in your teammates. And second, you must be willing to compete. Dr. Mallard has both of those qualities in abundance. Reinhardt University has always prided itself in the ability to build relationships. That's who we are. We love and invest in each other. From the first time I heard Dr. Mallard speak, I knew she was the right fit to be our president. Her genuine Christ-like love for people is obvious. She cares about her team. Students, staff, faculty, administrators, alumni, trustees, we are all a part of that team. Dr. Mallard, thank you for caring about us, for believing in us, and for believing in Reinhardt University. In the past year, Dr. Mallard's competitive spirit has shown itself day in and day out. Her desire to grow Reinhardt into the very best private university in our region is ever present in her decisions and planning. She is passionate about her vision, and that passion is contagious. Dr. Mallard, I believe in you. We all believe that your vision, our vision, will become a reality. It's only a matter of time. Last fall, our football team adopted the following slogan, raise the bar. Dr. Mallard, you have raised the bar for our university. We, the staff, pledge to work with you as we attempt to get over that bar, and then be ready for it to be raised even higher. Thank you, and go Eagles.
My name is Deborah Marlowe, and I bring greetings on behalf of the Reinhardt Board of Trustees. President Mallard, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I want to affirm your selection as the 20th president of Reinhardt University. We believe you are the right person at the right time to lead our great school. We challenge you to accept your responsibilities, to continue leading with a sense of purpose and strategic vision. We charge you to perform the many duties of your office to the best of your abilities, always serving for the high purposes and welfare of Reinhardt. We further challenge you to serve as a role model for the Reinhardt values of faith, learning, and leading, constantly with a focus on our students' success. Under your leadership, may our students' knowledge, to paraphrase from Sidney Lanier, spread and span like the one who hath mightily won God out of knowledge, good out of pain, and sight out of blindness. The Board of Trustees assures you that in all you do, you will have the complete support of the community, trustees, faculty, staff, students, and religious and community leaders. We pledge to make our service and giving to Reinhardt a priority and to partner with you in making the best decisions for a bright and prosperous future for this great university. We are thrilled to have you at Reinhardt. We deeply appreciate all you have already accomplished, and we look forward with tremendous excitement to the years ahead. Thank you.
My name is Doris Ann Jones, and I'm the mayor of the city of Valeska. A warm welcome to each of you to being in our city today. It is hard to believe that a year has passed since you, Dr. Mallard, arrived in Valeska to be the 20th president of Reinhardt University. There are three words that I think describe you, Dr. Mallard. You are committed to caring. You care about Reinhardt University. I believe you care about our city of Waleska, and you care about Cherokee County. You have always had a very positive attitude every time I am with you. We are so happy that you chose Reinhardt and that we chose you, Dr. Mallard.
My name is Mark Roberts. I'm the Vice President and Dean for Academic Affairs. Dr. Mallard asked me 3 months ago if I would write a poem for this inauguration. That scared me to death. I am now an occasional poet. Thrive in the fullness of light. Here, where the goldenrod grows, here, where wisteria weaves about the pines, where the eagle flies from Brasstown Bald to Pine Log. Here, where the mountain winds down to Salicoa Valley, here, where the rich Etowah flows. Here, at the edge of Appalachia, here, between the city and the mountain, thrive. Thrive because you are uncommon. Thrive because you are rare. Because you are growing daily, ever keener, a Georgia aster, rays fanning, emerging in fall, blue bursting into community with wild flowers galore, thriving in the fullness of light, a rare vision in the strength of fields between mountain and city, radiant in your deep blue bloomery, bursting like a universe, creating a constellation of legacies. Here, thriving in the fullness of light. Let the musicians play the music. Let the warriors fight the fight. Let the artists make the art. Let the poets say the word. Let the thinkers think the thing. Let the doers do the deed. Let the singers sing the song that is beauty and truth.
Thank you.
That was beautiful. Thank you so much. Beautiful. Thank you. Before I introduce Dr. Mallard, I would like to make a few comments on the process of selecting our 20th president. I had the honor of serving as chairman of the search committee, and with the help of people like Dr. Jonathan Good, other board members, and peoples of the community, it was an extraordinary experience. As we thought about our 20th president, we had to consider certain factors and opportunities. You know, the university is almost 150 years old. We as trustees could not rely upon the reputation that Reinhardt had earned over the years. We could not relax and enjoy the hard work and growth Dr. Isherwood and Dr. Falany achieved while they served as a president of the university. Rather, our responsibility was to be aware of the needs and opportunities in the field of higher education. So in considering the university's 20th president, the trustees had in mind and considered certain relevant factors. One of which, or the first, is the location of Reinhardt. Reinhardt is in metro Atlanta. We're in close proximity to downtown Atlanta. We thought the new president should be aware of this, should acknowledge this, and use this as a tool in the growth and the expansion of Reinhardt's reaches. Another factor that is true in all of universities and colleges is attrition. Recent studies have shown that attrition is not a result of unhappiness or disappointment. Rather, in most cases, it's the inability of the student and his family to meet the financial obligations to keep that student in school. This is after you consider available loans, after you consider available cash. Studies show, believe it or not, that in some cases, just a few hundred dollars keeps a student out of school. So attrition is a concern, an ongoing concern. Attention should be given to academic scholarships. We need to concentrate on our scholars, our students who excel in the classroom, and ensure to keep them in school. Another factor that is somewhat surprising is that recent studies from the governor's office indicate that the university systems and the colleges are not producing sufficient graduates to meet the workforce needs, nor to keep the economic needs up for the state of Georgia. The governor has set a goal for 250 new students, new graduates, 250,000 additional college graduates or students with college credentials to meet this need. And his goal is to have this by 2025. That's a challenge, but at the same time, it's a great opportunity for universities like Reinhardt to take advantage of and to show that there is need and that we can produce students to meet the needs of the economic responsibilities of Georgia and needs of Georgia. And in addition to this, the university can serve in other ways. The student needs are obvious. I've just referred to that. But what is more impressive is with our proximity, there are needs for computer specialists, IT. The IT field is near us. The opportunity, the needs. Roswell and Alpharetta are producing thousands of jobs. And Reinhardt has an opportunity to fulfill or help fulfill those needs. Also, just as important are the needs for medical services. There's an acute need for nurses. There's an acute need for physical therapists. There's acute need for physician assistants or PAs. There's an acute need for diagnostic support staffs that provide x-rays, other diagnostic tests in our health facilities. Another newcomer on the scene is the entertainment industry. The film and TV economic impact in Georgia, listen to this, in 2007, it was $242 million. In 2015, it was $6 billion. In other words, a 2,500 increase impact on the Georgia community. The governor's office says the only threat of this advancing or succeeding is a lack of a workforce. These are just a few of the challenges and opportunities the Board of Trustees took in consideration when we selected our 20th president. And I can tell you without hesitation that the board felt very, very comfortable in selecting Dr. Kina Mallard as our 20th president to meet these challenges and to take advantage of these opportunities. I'm going to tell you a few things about Dr. Mallard, but I must tell you that we interviewed some 70 applicants from all over the country. But when Dr. Mallard came in and we started discussing the opportunities here at Reinhardt and her being our 20th president, she looked at us very seriously and she said, you know, when I arrived on this campus, I had a feeling, and that feeling was the good Lord wanted me to be right here. This is where I belonged. And we looked at each other and said, how can we argue with that? So we are very, very proud. Dr. Mallard, if you could come up here, and I will go over some of the achievements of your illustrious career. Of course, Dr. Mallard is going to be our 20th president of Reinhardt University. And she comes here from Carson Newman University. She has, in addition to being there, she has 30 years of experience in higher education. She served, as I said, at Carson Newman, most recently, as the executive vice president and provost. She has also served as academic dean at Gordon College in Massachusetts, associate provost and department chair at Union University in Tennessee. And something she has really, really impressed us with, and what is so really impressive, is that she enjoys this. She goes to the churches, she speaks to civic clubs, she gets the word out about Reinhardt, and she has been doing that since she's been with us for the past year. Dr. Mallard is a native of Knoxville, Tennessee. She graduated from Middle Tennessee State University with a BS degree in speech and theater. She earned the MA degree in organizational communications from the University of Tennessee and her doctorate or PhD degree from the University of Knoxville. As I said, she is married to Steve Dietz, and together they have 5 children and 1 grandchild. She believes and is building her tenure here on Reinhardt's historic values of faith, learning, and leading. Dr. Mallard has a vision to create a unique Reinhardt experience where each student thrives. This experience aims to enliven the university's present in order to enrich Reinhardt's future. It is a great pleasure that I introduce Dr. Mallard. Reverend Tim Emmett, this is Dr. Mallard's pastor and lead pastor of the Waleska United Methodist Church. Will now.
Kina Mallard, you have been called by God to lead Reinhardt University. This ministry is a blessing and a serious responsibility. It recognizes your special gifts and calls you to work among students, faculty, and staff. In love, we thank you for accepting your obligation and challenge you to offer your very best to the Lord, to this people, and to our ministry in the world. Do you this day acknowledge yourself as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ?
I do.
Will you devote yourself to the service of God in this place?
I will.
Will you live so that you may enable this institution to be a people of love and peace?
I will.
Will you do all in your power to be responsible to the task for which you have been chosen?
I will.
I present to you our 20th president of Reinhardt University.
Well, thank you, Chairman Hasty, members of the Board of Trustees, past presidents, Dr. Falany, Dr. Isherwood, faculty, staff, students, alumni, delegates, distinguished guests, friends, and family. I am honored and humbled to serve as Reinhardt's 20th president. This wonderful place, our university in a park, is a beautiful and inspiring campus with a beautiful and inspiring spirit. You have welcomed me and Steve with open arms and open hearts, and we are overwhelmed with the love we have felt. While I have the honor of standing before you, this inauguration is not really about me. This inauguration is a celebration of Reinhardt University and the many dedicated servant leaders who, through courage, innovation, and sheer will, have brought us to this day. Today we celebrate our founders, Augustus M. Reinhardt and his brother-in-law, John J.A. Sharp, who had the vision of bringing education to Waleska, Georgia, and asked the North Georgia Conference of the Methodist Church to send a preacher and a teacher to run Reinhardt Academy in 1883. Today we celebrate past and present trustees of Reinhardt. Trustees like Norman Paschal, who served as chairman of the board for 12 years and spread the name of Reinhardt College into Atlanta and beyond, increasing its profile and prestige. Today we celebrate past presidents who have greatly and positively influenced our history, each doing their part to move Reinhardt forward. Sharp, Branton, Burgess, Jernigan, Falany, and Isherwood. Today we celebrate our great faculty and staff. Staff like Doris Jones, who has worked in our business office, and faculty like Susan Naylor, who helped build our strong music program, Both Doris and Susan have served Reinhardt for over 40 years each. And today we celebrate our students. Students like Carlos Guzman, who fled Mexico with his mother for a better life in America. Carlos has excelled both in and outside the classroom, including an internship with Reynolds and Reynolds Financial Partners, who have already offered him a job when he graduates in May. His Reinhardt testimony: Reinhardt has changed my life. The university has inspired me to keep pushing even when things get tough. My philosophy is to have faith that no matter how bad life gets, God has a plan for everyone. The key is to trust that the faith God has in us is not misplaced. This university has given me more than I could ever repay. It has granted me the tools to be successful. I will forever be indebted to Reinhardt, for I am a living example that Reinhardt shapes lives and builds futures. This is what we celebrate today. A university whose spirit was captured in the words of noted historian Joseph Mahan, class of 1941, who wrote, "I am naive enough to think that cool, impersonal training in the rudiments of learning does not constitute education. There is a greater, more human quality which must be included. Reinhardt has furnished that additional quality and has given by precept the capacity for love." This afternoon, there are many I want to thank. First, thank you to Chairman Billy Hastie and the Board of Trustees. You have been encouraging and supportive. You have introduced me to donors, connected me with the community, invited me to speak at your civic organizations and churches, inspired me with your creative ideas, and supported this university financially. Thank you to the selection committee, who last February chose me to lead Reinhardt. It's hard to believe it's been over a year since I started thinking, dreaming, and planning for this university. To the many members of the community who are here today, from members of the Methodist churches across the state to community, city, and county leaders, I am grateful for your partnerships and your friendships, and Reinhardt thrives because of your support. I want to thank the staff who worked tirelessly contributing to their part of the Reinhardt experience. From the first time I stepped on this campus, when B.J. Cavanis, a member of the facility staff, described this place as having a spirit of peace, to just this week when staff in every department were ensuring every detail was taken care of for this day, Reinhardt staff are committed to ensuring our students are challenged with care and treated with respect. To Bonnie DeBoard, my executive administrative assistant who has worked for six presidents, thank you for making this transition easy for me, for your knowledge of every aspect and detail of Reinhardt, for your professionalism, and for not saying too many times, "Now Dr. Isherwood used to." To our impressive Reinhardt faculty, thank you for your commitment to our students, shaping them into scholars, helping them realize their full potential. You live out God's calling on your lives by your commitment to your discipline, your colleagues, and most importantly, your students, ensuring the integrity of an authentic education through a relevant curriculum, seeking ways to broaden the minds of your students and expose them to ideas and experiences that will transform their lives. Today, I am pleased to announce that thanks to the generosity of retired faculty and one of our educational partners, we have raised over $30,000 to fund one of the initiatives in our strategic plan, deepen academic relevancy. To deepen academic relevancy, we are creating a teaching and learning collaborative, which will bring experts to campus to facilitate robust, innovative, high-impact conversations and professional development for our faculty. To my leadership team, I am blessed to have a smart, experienced, energetic, forward-thinking, positive, student-focused leadership team, and I want them to stand. Those of you who know me will appreciate me saying to this group of leaders, thank you for keeping up with me. With this team in place, there is nothing, absolutely nothing, Reinhardt cannot accomplish. Reinhardt's future is in solid hands with this team leading the way. And now for the students. This past Wednesday night, the students planned their own event welcoming me to Reinhardt, and it was fabulous. Students from each school, from athletics, from the Student Government Association spoke, and the performing arts students entertained the crowd. The evening ended with an original composition by first-year piano student David Bussman. I am so proud of our remarkable students. Thank you to our student ambassadors who have helped today, and for the many students who are watching this right now in Bannister Glasshouse, I want to give you a shout out. And I want to say specifically to you, Reinhardt University exists for one reason, to educate you, the students, to stretch you intellectually, creating habits of an alive and curious mind, to challenge you spiritually, creating habits of a caring and empathic servant's heart, to mentor you socially, creating habits of respect, engagement, awareness, and to motivate you physically and mentally, creating habits of strength and wellness. Steve and I have welcomed over 1,000 people into our home since September, and 70% of them have been students. Together, we thank you for accepting us and for providing us with so many moments of great joy. Students, when you return in the fall, you will have lights on the football, lacrosse, and soccer field, providing the opportunity not only for night practices and games, but also for concerts and special events. You will have a larger and more beautiful Lake Mullinex with a walking path from Fincher Art Building to the Falany Performing Arts Center. And you will have the pedestrian concourse you've wanted in front of the Hasty Student Center so that every day can feel like spring day. These are the first steps to the beginning of our new campus master plan, which will, in the near future, see the completion of a new theater, a complete renovation and expansion of the Gordy Dining Facility, new residence halls, and a new nursing building. I want to thank the delegates from other universities and academic organizations. Your presence symbolizes that we are all connected in higher education, learning from each other and leaning on each other. Thank you to the many friends who are here to share this day, Steve's co-workers from Food Donation Connection, two of my past presidents, President David Dockery and President Randall O'Brien, and many former students, faculty, and staff from Union University, Gordon College, and Carson Newman University. There is nothing more encouraging than for me to look out and to see your smiling faces here today. Thank you for being here. And finally, my family. Thank you for being here to celebrate with me. Thank you for knowing what I need and when I need it. Thank you for being the best family I could ever imagine. My mother has already been recognized, but I wanted to say a couple of things about her and my dad. I'm sure that when I went away to college and chose theater as my major, my mom and dad wondered, what in the world is Kina gonna do with a degree in theater? Well, Mama, I guess I can lead a university. My mother and daddy modeled a strong work ethic. Every moment counted. They modeled a love of education, history, travel, and sports. Every moment was a teachable one. They were creative and resourceful. My father gave me a quick wit and a whimsical and playful sense of humor, and my mother gave me the ability to stand strong in the face of adversity. Their involvement in church modeled the importance of spiritual discipline and gave me a strong faith foundation. So today, to my mama, I say thank you. And last, but I think we can all certainly agree, not least, Mr. Steve. Steve is my best asset, and he loves Reinhardt. Those of you who know him can join me in appreciation for the enthusiasm, the love of students, and the many other contributions he brings to campus. Thank you, Steve, for sharing this journey with me. Reinhardt's future depends solely on how well we do our work in the present. Who Reinhardt will become in the next 10, 20, 30 years is being determined by the vision casting, strategic planning, personnel hiring, decision making, fundraising, curriculum developing, and campus and facilities designing we are doing right now. As a campus community, we've spent the last 9 months in assessment and feedback sessions, in chat and chews and town hall meetings. We've identified needs and opportunities, shared dreams for future programs, buildings, students. We've identified outcomes in retention and graduation and have started working toward achieving those outcomes. We've created a campus master plan and have the beginning work completed in our strategic plan. This year has been a year of reflecting on our rich past, understanding the realities of the present, and planning for an exciting future. It has been important work, and we have taken it seriously. And it has been good work, work that required us to bring our most creative and unique selves. And you, the faculty, staff, and students have tackled it with gusto. Thank you. The work we've already completed and the work we have before us will lend razor-sharp focus to our vision of creating a unique Reinhardt experience where every student thrives, and will be built on the three Reinhardt values we identified last fall: faith, learning, and leading. Interwoven into each of these values is Reinhardt's strong commitment to service. We are a community grounded in the Christian faith and the teachings of John Wesley, who believed that faith should be rooted not only in emotion, but also the intellect, a balance of head and heart. Scripture tells us that faith without works is meaningless. We read in the book of James, "What good is it if you say you have faith, but don't show it by your actions?" Faith by itself isn't enough. Unless it produces good deeds, it is dead and useless. The Reinhardt community I have come to love is one of faith in action. Faith that inspires our academic support director and members of the African Descendants Student Association to send over 7,000 books to universities in Nigeria. Faith that prompted business students, after a class discussion on supply chain management from a Christian perspective, to surprise their professor by collecting over 100 new toys for a nonprofit that helps older adults raise their autistic grandchildren. Faith that motivated students to travel to Nashville over spring break for a service learning opportunity focused on justice. The team worked at Thistle Farms, a ministry that serves women who have survived prostitution, trafficking, and addiction. They interacted with two freedom riders and heard their stories, planted trees and did yard work for a foster home, and visited Workers' Dignity, an organization where workers can turn when they feel they've been cheated from their wages. A spirit of giving is what sets Reinhardt apart from other institutions that neglect the spiritual dimension in a well-lived, well-balanced life. It's about service to God, and in so doing, is service to others. Reinhardt is a community that blends our first value, faith, with our second value, learning. The Reinhardt community I've grown to love knows that to understand the blending of faith and learning is to understand that one is not possible without the other. Elizabeth Coe Carnes, a harpist, earned her Bachelor of Music degree in 2014 and is an active freelance performer in Atlanta. She stated her Reinhardt experience this way: "I find it beautiful that God was able to perfectly weave together my love for serving his people with my passion and abilities in music. He is a God that nurtures our individual talents and never wants us to trade what is unique to us for something someone else can do." Brian Frey, class of 2010, used his learning to serve others by inventing Braille Touch, a revolutionary computer application that provides mobile texting for the visually impaired. Frey credits his professors at Reinhardt for setting the positive examples he needed to get where he is today, stating, "The biggest thing Reinhardt did for me was to get me excited about research. In one of my classes, I disagreed with a point in the textbook, and my professor encouraged me to do some investigating. This first venture into research turned into a monograph comparing different texts, and Brian published his first paper before he graduated. For Frey, the Reinhardt experience was the experience I needed to build the foundation for my future endeavors. And I believe Brian is here today. I can't see out there, but Brian, thank you for saying that about Reinhardt, and I appreciate you being here." While on maternity leave, Shonda Bell, class of 1994, combined her Reinhardt education with 6 years of teaching experience to write a children's book with her mom about the elf family tradition they had in their home growing up. The first book, The Elf on the Shelf, A Christmas Tradition, has morphed into a thriving business with 13 books, an animated Christmas feature, Elf Pets, digital apps, and elf clothing, affectionately known as Claus Couture. She attributes Reinhardt for starting her on the path to success, stating, "It was small enough, yet big enough, for me to sprout my wings as a leader. Reinhardt allowed me to be my best me." Current students are also experiencing using what they learn at Reinhardt in the service of others. This past spring break, faculty and students traveled to Mexico, where they distributed 260 bags of school supplies and helped to build a cistern system in the village of El Tablon. A business class provided spring break for Goshen Valley Ranch, a home for 46 boys who are in the Georgia State foster care system. And Reinhardt students tutor and mentor Hispanic families at the Mia Familia Center in Canton. Faculty, staff, and students generously share their expertise and talent at civic clubs, chamber member meetings, special events, and through the newly launched President's College, a community connection for lifelong learners. These are just a few examples of blending learning and faith through service and living out the true spirit our university seeks to create and foster. At Reinhardt, we have a robust appetite for learning. And as C.S. Lewis reminds us, God makes no appetite in vain, saying in his essay, Learning in Wartime, "We can therefore pursue knowledge as such and beauty as such in the sure confidence that by doing so, we are either advancing to the kingdom of God ourselves or indirectly helping others to do so." Faith, learning, leading. From its beginning in 1883, Reinhardt graduates have sought opportunities to lead. Dorothy Rogers Tilley, an 1899 graduate, was Georgia's most prominent white woman civil rights activist. A member of Harry Truman's Civil Rights Commission, she was a force for racial equality and social reform, mobilizing church women to prevent lynching, boycott businesses owned by the Ku Klux Klan, and fight poll taxes in the South. Over 100 years later, 2005 alum Dr. Carlos Candina Gatton was named the 2015 International Future Sustainability Leader, chosen from more than 100 nominees across six continents. Gatton created a World Bike Forum, an innovative approach towards promoting urban sustainability. The announcement of his award talked about Gatton this way: "He is an astonishing inspiration for leaders around the world on how to mobilize people, create change in your local community, and see the international effects. The Reinhardt community I've come to love has many, many outcome stories we could tell of our servant leader alumni. From Marguerite Klein, who served as the first female mayor of Waleska and the first female superintendent of schools, to Dr. Brian Hightower, recently named the new superintendent of Cherokee County Schools, who will be honored tonight as Reinhardt's outstanding alumnus. There are markers in the life of an institution that remind us how far we've come and how much our work really matters. An inauguration is one of those markers. Wendell Berry boldly writes, "The thing being made in a university is humanity. Human beings in the fullest sense of those words, responsible heirs and members of human culture. Underlying the idea of a university is the bringing together, the combining into one of all the disciplines. It is the idea that good work and good citizenship are the inevitable byproducts of the making of a good, fully developed human being. The focus at Reinhardt is always on the success of our students. Central to our mission is providing a unique Reinhardt experience that educates the whole person, weaving together our passions and God's plan, building the foundation for future successes, helping students sprout their wings as leaders, and shaping lives and building futures. We are about the work of making humanity, shaping educated servant leaders for the future. What awesome work God has given us to do." In 1876, Daniel C. Gilman, the first president of Johns Hopkins University, expressed the hope that American universities would one day make for far less misery among the poor, less ignorance in the schools, less bigotry in the temple, less suffering in the hospital, less fraud in business, and less folly in politics. Reinhardt graduates are equipped to do just that, to enter the workplace with the mind and heart to not only be the best in the world, but to be the best for the world. My hope and my prayer, my inspiration and my motivation, is that when the future presidents of Reinhardt are inaugurated, they will look back at our time in history, our time in shaping this great university, and will say with appreciation that we have been true to our students, true to our mission, and true to our God. Thank you for being here today to celebrate the great future of Reinhardt University. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you join with me in singing our university anthem, Reinhardt, Reinhardt? The words can be found in your program. Would you stand with us and sing?
Oh,
Before we have our benediction, I would like to express gratitude to Joellen Wilson, Tim Norton, Bunny DeBoard, and Dr. Martha Shaw, who made this event possible. We thank them. Also, I'd like to express additional gratitude to the Board of Trustees. You did an outstanding job, obviously, in selecting our 20th president. So now we can kind of relax and turn everything over to Dr. Mallard. But job well done. Finally, I would like to express gratitude to my wife, Martha. She has been very patient in this process, and I thank you. Thank you, and now we have a benediction. And this is a very special friend of Dr. Mallard. It's Mr. Jimmy White. He's Director of Human Resources at Carson Newman University. Thank you for being with us. Have a benediction.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the significance of this occasion. And as we celebrate this event, we also celebrate and recognize that you are at work in blessing this university and its newest leader. For those of us who know and love Kina Mallard, it's clear that Reinhardt is the answer to her prayers. For those of us who know and love Reinhardt, we can clearly see that Dr. Mallard is the answer to the prayers of this university. And so it is, Father, that we draw this special event to a close with great joy and hope for the future. Just as you have answered the prayers of Dr. Mallard and Reinhardt University, we now wait with great anticipation to see what you will do in a future filled with days that will enrich the lives of this university, its students, faculty, staff, alumni, and community. As we leave this place, we are reminded once again, Father, that you have promised to always be with us. And we cling to that assurance as we move into the future with the faith that you will bless this university and its leader in ways beyond even what we can imagine. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, amen.
We will now sing Grace and Gladness, the choral benediction.